In this problem, we're given a quadratic function in general form. We want to find the x-intercepts, the y-intercept, the equation of the axis of symmetry, the vertex, and then graph the function. So let's start with a quick review. The graph of a quadratic function produces a parabola, as we see here, and it would open up if a is positive, it would open down if a is negative. The points where the parabola intersects the x-axis are called the x-intercepts. Notice this parabola has two of them, one here and one here. Notice that points along the x-axis would always have a y-coordinate equal to 0, which tells us that in order to find the x-intercepts, we'll set y equal to 0 and solve for x. The point where the parabola intersects the y-axis would be the y-intercept, which is this point here. Notice that points along the y-axis would have an x-coordinate equal to 0, which means to find the y-intercept, we'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Next, this green line is called the axis of symmetry or line of symmetry. You can see that it cuts the parabola in half, or we can say the parabola is symmetrical across this line, meaning if we fold the parabola across this green line, it would match up perfectly with the other half. And as long as the function is in general form, as we see here, the equation of this vertical line will always be x equals negative b divided by 2a. Every parabola also has a vertex. If the parabola opens up, like this one, the vertex is the lowest point on the graph, which would be this point here. If the parabola opened down, the vertex would be the highest point on the parabola. But notice how the axis of symmetry passes through the vertex, which means the equation of the axis of symmetry tells us the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice they're both equal to negative b divided by 2a. And then to find the y-coordinate of the vertex, we just substitute this value into the function and evaluate. So now let's go back to our problem. We'll start by finding the x-intercepts, so we'll set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Remember, f of x is equal to y, so we'd have the equation 0 equals x squared minus x minus 6. This is factorable. The factors of x squared would be x and x. The factors of negative 6 that add to negative 1 would be negative 3 and positive 2. So our solutions are x equals 3 or x equals negative 2, which do tell us our x-intercepts, but we do want to list them as ordered pairs. So one x-intercept would be 3, 0, and the other x-intercept would be negative 2, 0. Next, to determine the y-intercept, we'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y. And since f of x is equal to y, we would have y equals 0 squared minus 0 minus 6, so we have y equals negative 6. Again, we want to give this as an ordered pair, so it would be the point 0, negative 6. Next, to determine the equation of the axis or axis of symmetry, we use the equation x equals negative b divided by 2a, where a is equal to 1 and b is equal to negative 1. We don't need c, but c would be equal to negative 6. So again, we have a equals 1, b equals negative 1, so x equals negative b over 2a would be negative negative 1 all over 2 times 1, which would simplify to 1 half. And this is a vertical line, so we do want to express this as an equation. It would be x equals 1 half. And now to determine the coordinates of the vertex, we know the x-coordinate would also have to be 1 half, and then we'll substitute x equals 1 half into our function to determine the y-coordinate. So f of 1 half would be equal to 1 half squared minus 1 half minus 6. So we'd have 1 fourth minus 1 half minus 6. This is going to be negative 6 and 1 fourth. But one thing that's often helpful is to express these as decimals, since we will be plotting these on the coordinate plane. Now let's take this information and sketch the graph of our parabola. I'm going to start by sketching the axis of symmetry. which is x equals 1/2, that would be this vertical line here. Next, our vertex is 1/2, negative 6 1/4, or in decimal form, 0.5, negative 6.25. Remember, this point will be on the axis of symmetry. It's going to be right about here. Now let's plot our x-intercepts. We have the point 3, 0 here, and the point negative 2, 0. Notice how these two points are symmetrical across the axis of symmetry. And then we also know the y-intercept is the point 0, -6, which is here. And because of the symmetry across the axis, we know there would be another point on the right side of the axis of symmetry here. Now this is probably more than enough information to make a nice graph of the parabola, but I'm going to go ahead and find a couple more points. Let's evaluate the function at x equals 2. F of 2 is equal to 2 squared minus 2 minus 6, this would be 4, minus 2, that's 2, minus 6 is negative 4. Remember, this is telling us that the point with coordinates 2, negative 4 is also on this parabola. So let's go ahead and plot that point. 2, negative 4 would be here. And then again, because we have the axis of symmetry sketched, we know there's going to be another point on the other side of this vertical line right here. And that's why it's so helpful to sketch the axis of symmetry. For every point that we find, we actually find 2. So this would be the graph of our parabola. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.